Hello, and in this PIC programming tutorial, I'm going to be covering how to interface with a keypad. The hardware setup is going to be a 3x4 keypad with four of the pins connected as outputs to the B port. The other three pins of the keypad are going to be connected to the B port as inputs, and the input pins are going to be pulled down low with a 10K resistor. Now let's get into how a keypad works. Now, a keypad works by having its pins multiplexed in the order shown here. So 1, 2, 3 are connected together. 4, 5, 6 is also connected together. And then 7, 8, 9 is connected together. And then hash or pound, or whatever you want to call it, 0 and star key is connected together. And then vice versa, 1, 4, 7, pound is connected together. Then 2, 5, 8, 0 is connected together, and then 3, 6, 9 star is connected together. Now for reference, RB0 is going to be equals to 0, then all the way to RB7 is going to be equals to 7. Now my connections for the 147 hash line is going to be 0, so RB0. Then 2580 is going to be connected to RB1. And then 369 star is going to be connected to RB3. And then 123 is connected to RB4. And then 567. So how I'm going to program this is basically 0 to number 2 is going to be inputs. And then 3 to 6 is going to be outputs. So in essence, what you're going to do is you're going to push RB3 high, then RB4 high, then RB5 high, and then RB6 high. Now every time we push one high, we set all the others low. So in essence, what you get is you're going to jump like this, and then jump like that, and then jump like that. And then you're going to return and jump back to RB3. So this will give you a hexadecimal code for each individual key. So say you press 1, RB3 and RB0 will be high. So 1 will be equate to 0 and 3. And then the key 2 will be 1 and 3. And then 3 will be 2 and 3. And then you can also see here with the color coding how it looks. And then for the next set, 4, 7 and hash will always be 0, and then they will go 4, 5, 6, and then for 5, 8, 0, all the inputs will be 1. So we have 5 as a 1, 8 as a 1, 0 as a 1. For 3, 6, 9 star, the input will be number 2, so number 2 gets 2, 9 gets a 2, star gets a 2. All the lines 4, 5, 6 will output on number 4. So you got 4 on number 4, then you got 4 on number 5, and then 4 on number 6. And then 7, 8, 9 is going to be 5, and then 5 as your output, and then hash pound 0 star is going to be 6. So we already have our 6 here, and then 6. And then 6. And then you're going to translate this to hexadecimal code. Now with the basic working done, let's get to the coding. Now something of note, I have upgraded the compiler and the IDE since the last tutorial. So the only thing that changes, this include over here, becomes PIC instead of just P18F. The interrupt service routines change to this declaration. And that's the only difference I have encountered so far between the two different compilers. So the setup is fairly simple. We just have something to indicate our program has started. We have a buffer to do our printouts with. Then we set the oscillator to 8 MHz. We set TRISB, and then we set our outputs. And we initialize the UART at board 9600. And we just have a delay start, and then a printout to indicate our program has started via the UART. Nothing in the interrupts. And the first thing we do is we set our TRISB from RB0 to RB2 as inputs with RB 3 to RB7 as outputs, and RB7 is not connected. Then we set RB0 high. Now the first thing we're going to implement is line scanning. So what we are going to implement is the section I'm going to highlight now, this piece of code that effectively runs from RB3 to RB6, that sets them high. Okay, I just noticed we're not setting RB0 high, we have to set RB3 high. So let B will be equals to 0x8. So we start with a function void, and we call it keypad line scan, and we give it void parameters, and then we give a static uint8, and we call it kscan. It's equals to 0x08. Now the static keyword just tells it, do not change the value of kscan in this function. This variable retains its value even if you exit the function. So then we take kscan is equals to kscan bit shifted by 1. Then if kscan is greater or equals to 0x80, then kscan is equals to 0x08. Let B is equals to k_scan. And we quickly just save that. Okay, then we take our function here and we smack that into our forever loop. And just for note, this can also be while 1. So we will forever be the counting the variables up, down, up, down. So just to reiterate, this will set only one pin high on the port at a time. The next thing we're going to do is read the input port. So we start with a new function, we call it void, and we say keypad read, and we give it a void. The first thing we check is if port B, then we do a logic AND, 0x07 is not equals to 0. Now what this does is, if any input line is high, do stuff. So this actually just checks is RB0 to RB2 high. So if any of them are high, this will be not equals to 1. Then in the if, we create a variable of uint8, and we say that's the key value, so the raw value of the key is equals to port B. And we take a quick sprintf just to show the value on the UART. So I'm literally just taking key value and then putting that into an sprintf. Then I'm going to print that on the UART. Let me just check why there's an error here. uint8_t and key value, and then key value. Let's make that key value. Okay. Now that that's resolved, we have a successful build, but I need to call this actually in the while loop. So the compiler doesn't seem to like the way you usually format strings. So I just changed this printout. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't fit everything into frame. But if I press 1 on the keypad, you can see it comes out as 41 hex. And then 2 is 42 hex. 3 is 44 hex. 4 is 94 hex. 5 is A4. C4 for 8, 11 for 7, 12 for 8, 14 for 9, star is 21, 0 is 22, and then hash is 24. Now back to the code. Now we need to translate these values to actual usable values. So we are going to create another function with void parameters, and we're going to call it key pad to value. And that's going to take in a uint 8, and that's going to be the port value. And then we are going to input a pointer of uint 8, and that's going to be the value. That's going to be the raw number, the decimal value. Another pointer of uint 8, and that's going to be the character value. So basically the ASCII value for that character. And we start with the switch. We say port value, and then we say case and break, and we're going to have no defaults. So we're going to test through the values, and as you've seen before, I have written down these values already. So our number one is going to be 0x41 in hex for the port value. Of the pointer value is going to be equals to one decimal, and then the character value is going to be equals to the character one. So this is how you declare character values. And then we just repeat this case and switch for 12 values. So we just go whoom down. Okay, and I'll get back to you once this is done formatted. Okay, so now we're back. Now we have the entire case switch statement here for all the values. So each port value corresponds to a character value, and then we also return the decimal value via the pointer. So then in our, also saw a spelling mistake, let's remove that. Then we take the keypad value function. We go down to our keypad read function. We place that in. Then we give it k value. Just double check that's not a pointer. No. Then we create another uint 8, and that will be key character, or char for short. And that will be equals to 0. Then we reference our key value as the output pointer, and then we also reference key character value to our output character. Then we can remove these two lines. Then we create a new print statement that gives us the decimal value and the character value of the keypad. And that needs to go after keypad to value. And then we just take UART string print and we print that out. And we do a quick compile. Compile is happy. Program the pick. So we have a random printout now on the screen that shows the characters that are going to be displayed. That's actually a bug in the code, but I can't be bothered to fix it. So if we press 1, we get 01 as our output, and then our character as well as 1. And if we press 2, we have a 2 decimal value. And we press 3, we have a 3 as our decimal value. And then we can just go through 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, star, 0, and then hash. So you can see each and every single key is printing out a value now. So that's how to program a keypad with a PIC microcontroller. All of this is applicable to any other microcontroller you want to do. The code will be up on Git. Any ideas on what you want to see, please let me know in the comments. And thank you. Have a nice day. Okay, now as you can see on screen, there's a random printout that has the characters in it. Now, if I press 1, you can see a lot of repeated ones and zeros. For some reason, my line is not returning.